हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू? कैसे हैं आप लोग? विशिंग यू अ वेरी वेरी गुड हेल्थ, सेफ एंड साउंड, स्टे एट योर होम। दोस्तों, आज मैं एक वीडियो लेके आया हूं आपके लिए एसिम्प्टोट्स के ऊपर। एसिम्प्टोट्स जिसकी चर्चा हम लोग करते तो हैं, बट वी डोंट रियली गो इनटू द डेप्थ ऑफ फाइंडिंग एसिम्प्टोट्स। सो दिस कंसेप्ट इज गोइंग टू बी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू नॉट ओनली इन योर जेई मेन, जेई एडवांस एंड अदर कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स, बट इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू हेल्प दोज SAT aspirants and advanced placements aspirants who are basically targeting colleges abroad. तो बिना समय गंवाए हुए आइए स्टार्ट करते हैं आज का वीडियो। तो दोस्तों, सबसे पहले समझते हैं what is the definition of asymptotes. दोस्तों, एसिम्प्टोट्स तीन प्रकार के होते हैं। देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ एसिम्प्टोट्स। वन इज कॉल्ड हॉरिजॉन्टल एसिम्प्टोट, जहां पे आपका एसिम्प्टोट पैरेलल होता है एक्स एक्सिस से। एक होता है वर्टिकल एसिम्प्टोट, जहां पे आपका एसिम्प्टोट वाई एक्सिस के पैरेलल होता है। एंड थर्ड वन इज एन इंक्लाइन एसिम्प्टोट, एन एसिम्प्टोट विच इज मेकिंग सर्टन एंगल, सर्टन नॉन जीरो एंगल, ऑफकोर्स नॉट 90 डिग्री विद द एक्स एक्सिस। सो विल टेक सम एग्जाम्पल वेर विल ट्राई टू फिगर आउट दीज थ्री केसेस वन बाय वन। So let us begin with horizontal and vertical asymptotes.
All right, let's find out the horizontal asymptotes for this curve. So for finding the horizontal asymptotes for this curve, we focus on what is the highest power of x present in this given equation. So as you can see, I've already pointed out x square is the highest power of x present in this expression, right? So group up your x square terms so as to know what is the coefficient of that x square term, or what is the coefficient of that highest power of x present in that entire equation. Okay, take this coefficient, equate it to zero, and there you go, your job is done. So once you equate it to zero, you end up getting y minus 1 equal to 0, which clearly implies y equal to 0 and y equal to 1. So these two horizontal lines basically are the horizontal asymptotes for this equation. All right, now talking about vertical asymptotes. For the vertical asymptotes, the process is more or less the same. Now we identify what is the highest power of y occurring in this expression. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to find out what are the highest powers of y occurring in this expression, which is clearly y square, which is present at these two positions. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to collect all these y square terms together, and I have figured out that x square minus x happens to be the coefficient of y square. So equate this to zero, equate this to zero, and that is all you need to do to get your vertical asymptotes. So now, as you can see, this implies that x could be zero and x could be one. So these two are your vertical asymptotes. So this is how we end up finding our horizontal and vertical asymptotes for a given equation.
Now friends, let's look at a scenario where there is a possibility of an inclined asymptote.
Coefficient of the highest power of y, which is y cube, is actually a 1, which is a constant. This signifies that this curve doesn't have a vertical asymptote, right? So one thing is for sure, there is no vertical asymptote. There is no vertical asymptote. Okay. Now, similarly, could we figure out whether it has a horizontal asymptote or not? Well, let's try to figure out what is the highest power of x present. So as you can see, the highest power of x present is x cube, which has a coefficient of 2. Now, 2 being a constant, it means there is no horizontal asymptote as well. So there is no horizontal asymptote for this given curve. Now, that only leaves us with the option that there could be inclined asymptotes. Now, what are inclined asymptotes? Of course, as the name itself suggests, these are asymptotes which are making a certain angle with the x-axis. So basically, a curve has a inclined asymptote when this asymptote looks like y equal to mx plus c. So basically, it has a non-zero slope, and of course, it may or may not have a y-intercept. So let's try to figure out if there is any inclined asymptotes over here or not. And for that, we need to figure out what is m and c values possible. Okay. So to find m value, let me take you through an algorithm. Now, this algorithm I will not be proving in this video because it will unnecessarily stretch the video. So that proof can be, you know, seen in a separate video of mine, which will be coming very, very soon. So now I'm going to take you through a simple algorithm which will help you to get the value of m and c if at all there is a inclined asymptote possible for this curve. So what is the algorithm? So first step is, we collect all the highest degree terms together. So as you can see, the highest degree terms are y cubed minus 2xy squared minus x squared y plus 2x cubed. Okay. In this expression, we put our y as m. So put y as m and x as 1. So when we do that, we end up getting something like m cubed minus 2m squared minus m plus 2. Okay, we will call this as a polynomial in m of degree 3. So we will write it as phi 3m. Okay, now the value of m that I was talking about in this case, to get the value of m, what you have to do is, we have to put, let me write it as a second step, you have to put the polynomial phi 3m as 0. Okay, so when you do that, you will be getting some values of m from there. So let's figure it out. I think this is very easily factorizable. You may take m square, m minus 2, minus 1, m minus 2 equal to 0. So this is actually giving you m square minus 1 times m minus 1, m minus 2 equal to 0. And this is easily factorizable. Okay. So this throws out 3 values of m at you. Okay, so what are the values of m that you get from here? One is a 1, other is a minus 1, and the third one is a 2. Okay, now for these corresponding m's, we now need to figure out what is the c value. Okay, so to get the c value, there is a very interesting formula, or there's a very interesting algorithm. Again, I will give this without a proof to you. So c basically is found out by a very interesting formula, which is c phi 3m dash plus phi 2m equal to 0. Now you must be wondering, what is phi 2m? Because phi 3m I have already discussed in step number 2, but what is phi 2m? So phi 2m, for that you need to see what are your second degree terms in this given expression. So these are your second degree terms. Okay. In this, you just have to put your y as m and x as 1. So this becomes your phi 2m. Okay. So the process is exactly the same as we use for phi 3m. So here, so for phi 2m, you have to just take your second degree terms of this expression and put y as m and x as 1. So that is nothing but 3m square minus 7m. Okay. Now, let's figure out the c values for each of these m's. So we'll start with m is equal to 1 value. So my c will come out by the use of this formula which I have written here. I'll just simplify it a bit. Okay, so minus phi 2m divided by phi 3 dash m. Okay, so minus phi 2m means negative 3m square minus 7m divided by phi 3 dash. Now you need to differentiate this. You need to differentiate this like this and put your m value as a 1. So in this case, the answer that you will end up getting is negative of negative 4, which is plus 4, divided by 3 minus 5, which is minus 2. So you'll get C value as a negative 2. Okay. So one of the asymptotes, so one of the inclined asymptotes that you will end up getting is y is equal to mx plus c, so which is nothing but y is equal to x minus 2. So this is one of your answers. Okay. In a similar way, we can also plug in value of m as minus 1 and get the second inclined asymptote. So let us do that as well. So I'll write it over here. For m equal to minus 1, I will use the very same formula. C is equal to minus phi 2 m by phi 3 dash m, which is nothing but, let me just copy this from here, minus of 3m square minus 7m whole divided by 3m square minus 4m minus 1. So putting a minus 1 will give you minus 10 by 6, right? So this gives you nothing but negative 5 by 3. So y is equal to negative x negative 5 by 3 is your another inclined asymptote. Okay. Now similarly, I'll be also using my value of m as 2. So let's see, what do we get from there? M as 2, I'll get my answer as negative 3 into 2 square, which is 12, minus 14 upon 12, minus 8, minus 1. So that gives you around 2 divided by 3. So that gives you the third inclined asymptote as y is equal to 2x plus 2 by 3. So this is your third inclined asymptote. Okay. Now, dear friends, here you must be having a question. And that question would arise if you think this slightly harder. You see, in your formula of C, there is a phi 3 dash m coming over here. But what if this phi 3 dash m becomes a zero? Right? It could very well happen that your denominator term over here may become a zero when you put that particular value of m. Now, when will this happen actually? I'll tell you when will this happen. When phi 3 m will have a repeated root. Okay? So when phi 3 m has a repeated root, there is a chance that your denominator becomes a zero. Because when roots are repeated, then that particular root will also be satisfying phi 3m and will also be satisfying the derivative of phi 3m, right? That's how it happens. When the roots are repeated, the root not only satisfies the original equation, but also satisfies the derivative of that given polynomial equation, right? So now we are going to take a case like that, where I will tell you how does this formula of finding C gets modified if there is a repeated root occurring. All right, so let's look into this question. Now again, let's start with our analysis of vertical and horizontal asymptotes. Does it have a vertical asymptote? Let's try to figure it out. So for vertical asymptote, we'll check. What is the coefficient of y cube? Y cube coefficient is coming out to be negative 4. So what does it mean? It means no vertical asymptotes. Okay. So for finding horizontal asymptote, we need to equate the coefficient of x cube to 0. But x cube coefficient is a constant, which is 1. So that means there is no horizontal asymptotes. Okay, now let us figure out whether it has an inclined asymptote. So we'll follow the same mechanism as I discussed with you in the previous problem. So first, I will choose the highest degree terms, and highest degree terms are x cube minus 3x square y minus 4y cube. And in that, I'm going to put my y as m and x as 1. So as you can see, we will end up getting this guy, right? So this used to be our step number one, right? In step number two, we used to equate this to 0 and see what are the values of m that will come out from here. Okay, so in the interest of time, I'll directly give you the result. This will give you the value of m as 1, minus half, and minus half, right? So what do you see here, dear students, that this has got repeated roots. This has got repeated roots. Now, let's try to figure out how do we find out the value of c when there is a repetition of roots of m happening, okay? So I will take you to the third step over here. So if you see, the very first value is 1, which is not repeated. So for this, we can use our normal formula. And the normal formula, as we all know, is, I'll just write down the formula once again. So it is C phi 3 dash M plus phi 2 M equal to 0. So that gives you C value as negative phi 2 M by phi 3 dash M. Okay. So negative phi 2m. Okay, let's figure out what is phi 2m. Oh, there is no phi 2m. There is no phi 2m because there is no second degree term over here. So that clearly means this is going to be 0 by something. Correct? This is going to be 0 by something. So again, let me just complete it for the sake of completing it. So phi 3m derivative is going to be 3 minus 12m squared. 3 minus 12m squared. And if I put m value as a 1 over here, it still ends up giving me a 0. So y is equal to x. This happens to be my one of the inclined asymptotes. Okay. Now for repeated roots, this was for m equal to 1. Now for m equal to minus half, which happens to be a repeated root, the formula is going to change slightly. How is this formula going to change? All of you, please see here. The formula is now going to become c square by 2 factorial phi double dash 3m plus c by 1 factorial, which you can skip writing, phi 2 dash m plus phi 1 m equal to 0. This is the change in the formula that will happen. So instead of a linear expression in C, it has now become a quadratic in C. Okay. So from here, we can easily figure out what is my value of C when M is minus half, which again, I'm repeating, is a repeated root. Okay. So let's do the needful. So C square by 2 factorial. And if I differentiate this guy, I'll get minus 24M. Minus 24M. Plus, this is going to be C into 0. And my phi 1m, phi 1m is you take your first degree terms and put x as 1 and y as m. So that will become minus 1 plus m. So this will become minus 1 plus m. You can write 1 minus m as well. Okay. Put it to 0. And of course, let's try to solve it by putting our m value as a negative half. So it is going to give you C square by 2. And this is going to be a 12, and this is going to be a minus 3 by 2 equal to 0. Okay, so this leads to C square is equal to 1 by 4. So C is equal to plus minus half. Okay, so from here we end up getting two more inclined asymptotes, and those are y is equal to minus half x plus half. And y is equal to minus half x minus half. Okay, so these are our 1, 2, and 3 inclined asymptotes for this curve.
So I hope these videos were very informative to you. Please like, subscribe, and share.